Before the video starts, guys, be sure to use my support creator code CudiEdits. As you can see the screen right now, I have my support creator code. I've had it for the longest time. I've just never used it. So be sure to enter that as the item shop every 2 weeks. It does renew every 2 weeks. Go ahead and add me as your support creator, but let's go straight into the tutorial. What's going on, guys? It's your boy Cudi. We have a brand new video now. Today, guys, as you can see by the title of the video, I'm going to be showing you guys how to make a simple but clean paintbrush effect that you've seen in my latest Fortnite montage called Sakura Trip. Now, this was a highly requested montage. I know you guys wanted me to make a saber text tutorial, but I will be doing that later at a different tutorial. I'll make that one as well too, but for right now, this was just too highly requested. Everyone voted it. Obviously the higher vote was saber, but just in the comments, man, you guys were just killing it. You guys really wanted me to make this montage tutorial, so that is what I'm going to be doing here today. Now, I showed you guys a preview in the beginning, and as you can see, I'm on After Effects CC 2014. That is the only way you could do this effect. You can also do it, I believe, in Sony Vegas, but this is going to be After Effects. You do have to be kind of familiar with After Effects for you to follow along this tutorial. I won't be going too in-depth when it comes to the tutorial. Other than that, though, guys, let's go straight into the tutorial. As you can see here, I already have my clip synced. So I'm going to be showing you guys how I made that cool effect. I mean, let's just go straight into it, man, at this point. So you can see this very bottom layer. That's going to be my my audio here. And then this layer down here is going to be my basic layer for the clip itself. So right off the bat, what I want you guys to do is to go ahead and duplicate this layer. And this bottom layer, what we're going to do is we're going to go to look up CC Toner on color correction to effects and presets tab right here, and drag that over to the very bottom layer. And now I want you to change your midtones to some sort of gray area. This is going to be, so as you can see, if I disable with this little like eye over here to my left, if I disable it, it makes this kind of look like old school. So as you can see that from the preview, we'll be doing a lot of things like that too. But just to get it started off right off the bat, that's what you're going to do for the bottom layer. The top layer, you leave it alone as it is. What I want you guys to do is to go ahead and download a green screen paintbrush overlay. I already have mine downloaded, so I'm going to go to my project here and try to find it real quick because I know I have it somewhere in here. So I have my paintbrush green screen overlay here. I'm going to go ahead and simply control C and then control V and place it in this composition here. So you can see there's my paintbrush here. That's the one that I want to use right there. What I want you guys to do before we even continue with the green screen itself, now that you have the green screen in here, is look up key light on the effects and presets tab. So go ahead and look up key light and then drag that over to the green screen layer itself. And what that's going to do is if we click on this little button over here and then click on the green screen itself, it will get rid of the green screen, as you can see that. So that's how you kind of use green screens, and that's how you see a lot of people make cinematics with green screens, is that we're simply letting the computer know, hey, everything that's green in this layer, I want you to get rid of, which it does. So as you can see here, the paintbrush itself is now has a transparent background, which is really cool. And the background itself is the clip, which is really awesome. So I want my layer to start here. This is where I want my beginning of my green screen to start. So I'm gonna go boom, 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 boom. So I'm gonna simply resize this by dragging it and go ahead and scaling it up with clicking S on the keyboard and scaling it up and resizing it and positioning to the spot that I want it to be on. So maybe kind of do something like this. Boom, 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 boom. Okay, that's almost perfect. Probably scale it up just a tad bit more. And that's it. So if I zoom in, you can see here, boom, 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 boom. So now you're asking, Cudi, how do we make sure that it changes the layer? All we're gonna simply do, guys, it's so freaking simple how to make this effect. So once you have this set down, just like the normal paintbrush, what I want you guys to do is to go ahead and go click on this layer, the top layer that doesn't have the CC toner, and put it in the bottom layer of the CC toner. And what I want you to do is click on trick mat here. If you can't seem to find trick mat, like I have it right here on the screen, what I want you to do is click on the very bottom layer, bottom left, where it says expand or collapse transfer controls. You can't see because of the webcam I have, but pretty much learn how to open this up, and it's a button down here right next to my head. Like literally, it's like right around, like way down here. You can see it. I'm like highlighting on it. like right here, my mouse is next to the windows. Click on that, and it will, you'll see Trick Map pop up. It should pop up. If it doesn't, look up how to enable Trick Map. But anyways, go ahead and click on that. Click on the second layer. Click on none, and make it to Alpha Map Paintbrush Green Screen Overlay .mp4. And what that's gonna do is simply, you have the mat here, and it's gonna, the green screen now becomes the bottom layer. And so then it's like masking it in a cool way. And you can see here, it goes to old fashioned, and then boom, he shoots. And the moment he shoots, it's when it turns into normal coloring. So you can see here, boof, and that's literally it. It's a super simple effect. If you wanted to end the tutorial here, you could, but I'm gonna show you guys how to sync the actual paintbrush. If you know how to sync the paintbrush, then you should be perfect. But yeah, let me show you guys how to do that. So go ahead to the paintbrush layer, Control Alt T is enable time remap. If you don't know how to do basic editing on After Effects, this is not the tutorial for you. This is a more advanced tutorial for all those that know how to do that. Anyways, so I'm gonna go ahead and keyframe the beginning, and I'm gonna go ahead and keyframe the point in time where it goes to the other side. So there it is. I'm gonna keyframe the other point in time where it goes to the other side, which is there. And then again, other side, which is there. And then for the last final run, boom, touches it right there. So then now I'm gonna double click L on my music, and I'm gonna find out where this happened. So I wanted to, the last one I wanted to touch here. So I'm gonna grab this keyframe, align myself to it, and just simply drag the keyframes on the beat on the spot. Okay, so now that you have the basic syncing, right, we're aligned to them, we're gonna go ahead and highlight all of them, click F9, or right click and click on keyframe assistant easy ease. And this is the part where most people get confused. Just follow along, it should be easy, and I'm gonna show you guys what to do. So go ahead and click on the graph editor. And you can see here we have our normal wavy keyframes. If your graph editor does not look like this, but it looks like this, then it's completely fine, you're on the right page. If your graph editor does look like this, like S's, then be sure to right click and click on edit speed graph, because we'll be using speed graph for this specific tutorial. So what we're gonna do is, this is the first one here. We're gonna go ahead and drag it to the very far right and just gonna push it over here. Gonna move this to the very far left, and then just keep it far left. And I'm gonna mess with these keyframes, because all we're gonna simply do is, you can see I'm grabbing these knobs, going to the far left, and just pushing them to the far left. So let's go see how that looks like. And that's pretty much it, guys. I mean, obviously it's completely unfinished still. The effect could use some work. So if you guys want to, this is completely optional. What you guys can do to make this effect a little bit more cleaner is by having the Sapphire plugins and looking up us_film_damage. What this will do is make the edit look a little bit more cleaner. I added this on there. I remember it made it look really cool, and I liked it a lot. You can also change the blend mode within the CC toter. So if it's just too much black and white and you want it to have a little bit of color, what you can do is, you already see this blend with original right here in the top left for the CC toner. You can click it to 25%, 50%. The more higher the percentage, the more it blends with the original. So I'll put it to 25. So it gets a like slight, you know what I mean? A little bit there, a little taste of it. Or I'll just probably put 20 there instead. That'll be even better. And then we got our film damage. And then I'm going to go ahead and add a vignette. So let's see if we can do that via... oh yeah, we can add a vignette, even better. So I'm gonna add a vignette there, and that's pretty much it. I mean, after that, I'll probably add an S_flicker. And what this is going to do is make it a flickering effect. So like you'll see it. So what I mean by that is it's gonna simply just make it look and feel more like an old TVs, like from like the 1950s or so, like where it's just super old school. I have a preset for this made already, but I'm showing you guys how I'm making it as a whole. So you can see, like, I simply added some S flicker. Don't have to mess with the settings at all. The S film damage, all I did is went to vignette and increased the darkness right here by scrolling right, and that's about it. And then with the CC toner, I made it to the blend mode 20%. Let's go ahead and add a CC there to make it look a little bit more clean and more professional. And that's pretty much it, guys. I mean, obviously you can mess with the settings for like the vignette. So like I probably turn down the vignette just a tad bit because it's a little too much for me, in my honest opinion. The film damage is okay. The flicker is okay. I'll probably turn down the flicker to like 0.1 and or 0.04, or actually, yeah, 0.1 is perfect. And that's pretty much it though. Like there's more that you can mess with when it comes to the settings, but when it comes to the film effect itself, like the paintbrush effect, this is pretty much it, man. I love it. I love this effect. I usually use effects to make the edit just kind of indulge with it. Like I usually make effects to kind of bring you into the montage a little bit more. It adds more to the montage. It doesn't take away from it. So just make sure that whenever you guys use effects, you use them to pretty much just add to the montage. You're not taking away from it. Because if you see like a really choppy effect that just doesn't go with the song, it doesn't go with what's going on within the video, then it just kind of throws you off. It doesn't, you know, make you feel like you're actually immersed within the actual montage. But if you guys did enjoy this tutorial, please be sure to leave a like. If we can shoot for roughly at least, if this video ends up blowing up and I get roughly at least 1,000 likes, then I will make a complete tutorial series on how to make a montage from start to finish. And it will just be a complete series, and like step by step, like 20 minutes each on what I do and how I make my montages. And it's really simple, obviously. But once again, it's your boy Cudi, guys. If you have any questions, please be sure to leave a like, comment down below if you guys haven't already. And yeah, I'll see you guys on my next montage, next upload, whatever I decide to upload. And yeah, it's been your boy Cudi, so I'll see you guys later. Peace out. Reel it in, I got the bag, tell a friend, she got some mad.